Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. Last year, I was eating Thanksgiving dinner with my family, and we were all using silverware. Silverware, at least in my family, is brought out during special occasions, Thanksgiving, Christmas, and I'm sure many, many other families out there have a special set of silverware that they bring out during special occasions or holidays. And I thought to myself, why was the silver used in utensils, bowls, cups, you know, what have you? I believe I knew the answer, and my research confirmed my hypothesis, but my answers may surprise you in this video. I'm going to go over all the reasons why silver was used, and still is, in utensils, coming up. Welcome to Campbell's Coins. I hope you are all having a great Thanksgiving. Stick around to the end of this video because I have a huge, mega shout out to a bunch of people in this community, and I want you to stick around for that. But let's get to the video. So early civilizations knew the value of silver, and it didn't take long for them to realize its value beyond monetary measurement. The Stone Age equivalent of Anthony Bourdain and Julia Child were handicapped by the lack of cooking utensils and often ate with their hands. When the Copper Age arrived, it delivered better tools for cooking, but not for eating. Copper is a poor metal for making utensils because it has a very strong taste. The Bronze Age brought with it stronger metals, but they didn't taste any better. So eating with the hands continued in most parts of the world, except East Asia. There, they cracked the problem by developing chopsticks. That the rest of the world didn't adopt this remarkable invention is odd, especially when you consider that metal cutlery that didn't have a taste took more than another 6,000 years to develop. The first breakthrough in this quest was the discovery of gold utensils. In addition to looking fabulous, gold utensils are inert and do not interfere with the flavor of food or drink. They didn't know it at the time, but this is associated with the high electrode potential of gold, which means it doesn't chemically react with very many things. Since it does not react with food, drink, or indeed the mouth, it doesn't produce new compounds, and so it doesn't have much of a taste. Job done, you might think. Except that gold is very rare and expensive to be a practical choice for anything but kings and queens. In addition to being very malleable, like gold, silver is quite inert, but it has a lower electrode potential than gold, and so it does react with some foods and indeed the mouth, producing a mild metallic taste. It is rare, like gold, and expensive too, although not as much. Therefore, it's really only owned by the rich. More plentiful metals like copper, bronze, and iron have electrode potentials that are lower than silver, and these react with a lot of food and taste foul. Thus, for most of recorded history, those not using chopsticks either ate with their hands, with cutlery made from metals tasting quite strong, or from other nice tasting materials such as wood. But with the mild metallic taste of silver came additional benefits, which some may not realize. Silver is a safe metal because of its antimicrobial properties. Silver kills germs, bacteria, and fungi, and unlike other metals, it doesn't kill us because its toxicity is not at the level of other heavy metals. This is really important because of what we're going through right now, COVID. If people are worried about COVID or something else, maybe looking into getting some silverware because of its antimicrobial properties. Because of its properties, silver makes an ideal metal to use when touching our food. The ancient Phoenicians, Greeks, Romans recognized silver's antimicrobial properties on some level because they used silver to store wine, water, and vinegar, helping their drinks to retain their potency without spoiling. In more recent history, silver has been used to keep milk from spoiling. Before antibiotics were developed, silver was often used as a disinfectant. In fact, there is a theory floating around out there claiming the reason so many royal families escaped the bubonic plague in Europe is because they ate off of silver plates and used silver utensils. Eventually, in the 1700s, silver plating was discovered and they coated copper utensils, allowing the middle class to afford silver-colored utensils. In the 1840s, with the advent of electricity, electroplating was born, making cutlery even more affordable. It wasn't until 1913, when stainless steel was discovered, that we achieved an affordable, tasteless metal. Certainly not the most exciting of topics, but it's interesting to know the evolution of our utensils. Did you know the reason silver is used in silverware? Do you use sterling silver? Let us all know in the comments below. Before I end this video, I'd like to mention what I'm grateful for since it is Thanksgiving, and that is all of you, my viewers, my supporters. I'm very thankful for such great viewers and subscribers, for everyone that leaves a comment, smashes that like button, and for all of my subscribers, this is my shout out to you. As hard as I try to reply to everyone's comments, sometimes I don't get to it as quickly as I'd like. Eventually I do, but I wanted to thank everyone who drops a message for me and for others. Additionally, I don't always get around to watching everyone's wonderful YouTube channels. I'm really sorry about that. I'm really trying though, so please don't be too mad. But I thought I would like to announce a few people who I consistently notice showing some love on my page from video to video, and I'm just gonna bring this camera off. Okay, so this is in no particular order. Pistol Packing Pilot, Cactus Jack Swag, Aloha Stacker, 49's Fine Silver, Vertical Stacker, Ontario 100, II Ron Autry, Ramadan Burton, Bullion Addict, Jacob Parker on Love and Sublimation, JT Coin Rings, Sean Foltz, Saltwater Saddle Tramp, Silver Soup, Boxy's Precious Metals, Austin's Coins, Gold Maple, and Monty. Some of these guys have YouTube channels, others do not, but I still want to thank you because you guys are always there for me and I really do appreciate it. This list was not meant to exclude anyone. I see all of you and I really appreciate your support. That's gonna do it for me. Thank you all so much for watching. This is Campbell's Coins and that is my 2 cents. Have a happy Thanksgiving to all. We'll be right back.